Hey there guys, I'm Zerfall and welcome to C64 Sunday. Today we're going to be playing game number 48 on the Lemon 64 Top 100 as of August 31st, 2014. At the time, this game had an 8.51 and it still has a score of 8.51. However, an 8.51 is only good enough to get this game a 50. Interestingly enough though, the number of votes the game had before has only changed by 12, whereas some of these games, it's changed by a whole lot. So, it's kept roughly the same score as it had. However, it's not enough to get it going up the list. It's staying the same, roughly going down a little bit. Now, this is going to be a little bit of a quicker video because I don't have as much time to record right now. There's a lot of stuff going on. In my personal life, good and bad things that have happened to various family members that are really eating up my time right now, which is, I mean, I'm not complaining about it. I'm just saying that it is eating into my time to make videos. So I wanted to make sure I got C64 Sunday out of the way, though, because I'm trying to really stick to this time. Because it's something I've always struggled with. So I figure if I can keep this one thing constant on my channel, that'll be a good thing. So, this was a game that was published by Apex Computer Productions. The company that made it was Thalamus, and the developer as programmer was John Rowlands, and the graphician was Steve Rowlands, who I believe are siblings. There's not a lot of information on these guys out there, actually. They also did the game Mayhem in Monsterland that was covered in an earlier C64 Sunday, and everywhere I've looked I can't find a whole lot of information on these this programmer and this graphician, graphics artist. Steve Rowlands also did the music for this game, which you can hear right now is pretty kicking. We want to collect as many of these. Anyways, I've been trying to get more into the programmers after learning a little bit more about one of the programmers, because of someone who commented on Reddit, made me realize that I don't really look into the programmers so much as just the games that they've made. And it's unfortunate that that's been the case, because some of them have a lot of... I guess they can have a really interesting sort of life that they've led. And it might mean more to talk about who they actually were, more than just the games that they were a part of. However, for these guys, I don't have much more to say about them. They worked on a few games. There were a couple other ones that I didn't recognize the names of. They were actually... I just kind of want to pull that up real quick. I think I still have it around here somewhere. Here we go. The games were Retrograde, which I don't know if I recall that game, and Cyberdyne Warrior, which I think I mentioned before in Monsters, Mayhem in Monsterland, but not necessarily regarding the fact that I had recognized the game, just that I knew the name was there. So right now we have this typical drop shot, which we're going to use hopefully to good advantage here to kill a bunch of guys. The problem this game will face is things like this, where this monster is actually very hard to kill. So I'm just going to have to shoot at it with this crappy little shot that'll only hit it sometimes when I jump. And hopefully eventually he dies, because you only... There we go. We only have 2 hit points. It's interesting, though, because those creatures were linked together. So if you're killed by a creature, or not killed, but if you take 1 damage from a creature at the same time as... There, that did that guy in. I gotta be careful here. If I miss this jump, too bad. Okay, we want to get as much of these things as possible, because I should mention this real quick. These guys are gonna let us power up our attacks. Oh man, you better die. Okay. I can't get back up there now, but that's okay. We wouldn't have really gotten too much. Oh, it's the easy road. And you still get one of those things. That wouldn't have been so bad. Alright, something important about this little zone here. I don't know how you would have gotten through there. You can't shoot when you're on these little lily pads. You have to jump to shoot. And you'll see why that's kind of an issue in a little bit. It's one of my few complaints about this game. It's also interesting that sometimes those guys just fall down when they die instead of actually dying. Now this is one of the trickier jumps. There we go. We can't move when we're ready to breathe fire. Does everybody just dump down? No. Right, not so bad. We're actually gonna get quite a few of these little guys. So I'm gonna do really well for the first little bit of this level, but then it really ramps up the difficulty really quickly. Sort of the story about this game is that we're Clyde Radcliffe, who is the C and the R in Creatures, and I knew it was gonna hit me, but I couldn't do anything because I was holding down that stupid button. So you can take 2 hits per level. Hopefully we get to the... I believe this is the checkpoint here. Yes. So that's not too bad. You can hear the water in the background. There's a waterfall coming up. I don't know if there's supposed to be a way to get down in there. But here's where it gets annoying. Look at these stupid things. So we have to jump... to hit this guy, which really sucks because when we land, our little bombs go away. But there's guys like this guy here. I don't think there's a way for us to jump off when we're halfway down. I'm going to try it, but I'm pretty sure that... Yeah, see, you're stuck pretty much falling down here. Not much we can do. We can hit this guy. Then they do cheap stuff like this where they have some guy come ramming through super fast. And you've got to... do these stupid little jump hits to hit them, and they keep doing it over and over again. So these parts are sort of my worst or least favorite parts of the level. As we get away from this waterfall, that sound should sort of go away. And I can't even charge up a flaming attack to kill this guy with. Now once we've... Jesus. There we go. Yeah, it's getting a little quieter. I don't know that I can get up to where that cat is. I've tried it many, many times. You know, getting this jump at just the right spot, but regardless of where I seem to jump from... Oh, shoot! I normally don't make it, but this time I did! So we're not doing too bad. We're running a little low on time, but... Well, we're gonna jump across this hole. That should give us another... potion creature. And this is the part that I actually really hate, is this particular escapade spot here. So we're gonna die probably and end up back where we need to go. We need to see where this guy stops. It's roughly here. I never make that jump! Which is, I think, the only way to get through there without taking damage. So... we're gonna go through all this stuff again. Hopefully a little bit faster. If I hold down the button and jump, does it... No? Is there a way for me to stand on the edge of this thing? No, not really. So you can see how it's annoying. If you run right off the edge of this, you're going to hit that guy for sure. Oh man, that was a pretty close call. Another one of them here. I feel like they really should have made these guys one hit, because they're just such a pain. I guess you didn't really have to fight that one. And that little potion creature up there is already gone, so let's just move along a little quickly. So, I mean, this time we're going to... probably just going to walk through him. Like, I've tried shooting him a million times. He doesn't seem to flash, which means he's not actually taking damage. So we're just going to do this. What? Instant death! We're supposed to have 2 hits worth of damage! Jeez. Alright, so you can see my frustration at this part of the game. It's actually quite annoying. I don't know why they would program in such a crappy jump to have to do so early into the game. Maybe they didn't think it seemed that hard. But I tell you, not being able to shoot on this stupid little leaf really puts a damper on the situation. All right, we're not doing too bad. Do you know what? I'm actually going to throw it once I get down there safe. I know I can grab this guy to the left here, or to the right. Once I get down there, I'm throwing down a save state, because I think we've kind of earned one. In that, they've made that sort of ridiculously hard. So save snapshot, cheap jump. Hopefully we make it and not have to use that too much. Alright, so see where he stops. There we go. Okay, see, I just needed the... And you really can't kill this guy. Which is a bit of BS. Should be able to jump up here. Oop. Gotta get all the potion guys we can. Another one of these guys. Like, I swear, if this one can't be killed, I'll be quite upset. Because I don't know how you get past this one without... Like, are we supposed to be able to breathe fire at him to get him dead? Are you supposed to be able to make this jump? Maybe you can make the jump if you follow him, just like the other guy. Nope. But, oh, there's a guy up there you can kill to kill him. Okay, okay. That one's not as bad as I thought. There are monsters that are linked together, so we could have... That one's a little bit easier to figure out, but... What about the last one? He didn't seem to have a secret kill this guy first monster. And as you can see, you can't jump past the top of the screen, so we can do a little jib jazz here. So, the story of this game, I should really get to that, is that we're Clyde Radcliffe. And I wonder if I can breathe fire on my way down here, if that'll work. Well, it did and it didn't. He doesn't seem to be taking damage, so I'm not going to bother fighting him anymore. That guy's not taking damage either. What the crap is this thing? I probably could have shot it. Oh, good. It's got us in a new spot here, so this shouldn't be so bad. So what we got to do is this. Yeah, see? So, I mean, there's some things that are a little bit puzzly like that, but then there's other ones where it's clearly a good luck situation. We're creatures from another planet in the Milky Way. We were on a planet called Blobian or something like that. Or it's called Blot, perhaps, yeah. And we are Blotians. Okay, no, you can't kill them. Oh, come on! We are forced to leave the planet. We were the cute and changed our name to the Fuzzy Wuzzies. Now, this game came with a Fuzzy Wuzzy of its own, but we'll get to that in a minute. We are forced to leave the planet. They end up hitting an asteroid and crash landing on Earth. And on this island that they've landed on, they made a new home. They called it the raddest place in the galaxy, I believe. Or the hippest place in the known universe, perhaps, was the correct name. Do you know what? I really am going to say it. Put another save state down here. So we are down to our last life. And it turned out that this island was inhabited by demons. See, and that's... Oh, I guess we survived. And that's a real problem for us because... Nope. What about this? Yeah, not going to happen. Okay. Shoot. The island was inhabited by demons, and the problem with that is that the demons really hated the Fuzzy Wuzzy's awesome happy attitude, and the only way to get rid of that attitude is, of course, to kill the Fuzzy Wuzzies. They don't care to kill the Fuzzy Wuzzies. They're more upset by the fact that they've got this happy attitude, and they want to get rid of that. I think you can move a bit. Yeah, there we go. All right, we got a little bit of breathing room now, and I just realized we could have done this. Yeah, that's going to work. Which we should have done the whole time. Whoa, he's a trickster! I don't know if this guy's one I can hit. Oh yeah, he's getting hit. Right, we'll get him with the flame breath. I mean, their plan to destroy the fuzzy wuzzies was to... Oh, he tricked me! With a freaking worm gun! That's lame. Well, we're gonna have to probably go through this again. I am not likely to survive, I don't think. Unless this is an extra Radcliffe. Which it looks like it might be. Yeah, see, there's some things like that where you hit them with the flame and then they come to you or whatever. Yeah, it did seem like it was taking damage. Those kittens are demons, so don't worry about us killing them. Don't feel bad. That's what I'm trying to say. Alright, I'm going to throw in a little save down here because I'm concerned, and I have an extra life, so I'm kind of happy about that. Because I feel like this guy's going to start attacking if I get a little too close. What the heck is that thing? Alright, let's see where our load state is. This isn't so bad. And this guy's actually shooting early enough that I can expect that it's going to happen. There, see, like, if you know it's coming, it's not so bad. Oh man, we're actually going to be in a better position here because we can re-get this extra life. So we've reached one of those points in the game where they're like, yeah, we're not going to make that extra life unspun, so you pretty much have infinite chances here. Which I'm not going to complain about too much. Alright, so... Wait, no, we know there's going to be... Kill this guy. We know there's going to be some sort of fart showing up. This time we can jump over him. And then if we plan this right, can we hit him? Oh no, it's a respawning fart! Oh yeah, he's an asshole. Jeez. Alright, we can figure this out. I thought I had a charge to breath. So, their ultimate evil plan to destroy the Fuzzy Wuzzies is, of course, to have a big party, and in the middle of the party, they throw a net on top of them. And they've captured them, and they put them into torture devices. Because, let's try to make the game a little more inappropriate. So, the only reason why Radcliffe survived this capture is because he was so drunk so fast that he ended up in a bush, and they didn't notice him. So he woke up with a hangover. The hangover left him with breath powerful enough to ignite the tree. So our superpower is actually our hangover breath. I was hoping maybe I could breathe fire on this fart. Nope. He's gonna come back. I don't know how we're really supposed to get through there without taking damage. This is a little bit of BS. Oh! Wait. I had a life still. Game... Oh, the game froze out on me or something. Interesting. It seems to be loading when I press the button, but... Then nothing happens. What disk does it think is in? Oh, do you know what happened? Let's see what happens here. Oh man, we made it to the end. I didn't realize that. Okay. Somehow that counted as making it to the end of the level. I thought we died. But here we are. So we've got a bunch of things that we need to get ingredients. We have four out of four ingredients. There's different sort of powers here. Information is pretty expensive. You can get a scatter ball. We don't have enough for that. We could get... no. Okay, we could get ourselves the curly whirly, the wiggler, the fall up, Fireball, Super Droopy, and Droopy. So we already have Droopy. We could level up Droopy, which maybe is a good idea. We get ourselves Super Droopy. Oh, we could level that up again, actually. Why don't we go with this? So now we have a leveled up Droopy. Fireball is... Yeah, we don't have enough to get Fall up. We do have enough for the Wiggler. And that's going to be it for now. So now we have to go to exit. So this is the sorceress who has... is described as having a... fuzzy tick, which I can only imagine is a kink for fuzzy creatures. So let's go ahead and exit. We're going to be at the next level here, which is kind of impressive considering that we should have died there. Somehow we have two lives. Let's throw down a little bit of a save state just in case. Save snapshot. I'd like to get to the first torture chamber. If we could. So hopefully we can. Can we walk through here? No, we're going to have to go down and around. So our best bet is actually probably to get our fire breath saved up and then die. Okay, so what do we have equipped? Do we just have Droopy equipped? See, if we put on regular Droopy instead of super Droopy, it should be a little bit better here. Fire breath is still our best attack, I think, if we need to get in close to anything. There we go. Gotta collect more of them ingredients, though. Realistically, falling down is probably your best bet. So, we're trying to save our friends from these torture chambers, which, as I've said, I want to try to get to the first one here. This guy's gonna be kind of hard to get to. So if we press down, we can change to... I guess we got the curvy-wervy. There, so if we get them at just the right spot... Actually, if we walk back a little bit, we can probably... There we go. Make that a little easier. As far as reviews of this game go, I know I'm jumping around quite a bit here. I'm a little bit distracted, I guess, but, I wish you had different flame powers based off of... See, with no left scrolling, I don't know how, like, you're supposed to go back and get stuff here. Unless that's making him go back and get it for us? Doesn't make sense. Can we just walk out of here? No. Shoot. If we plan this just right, there we go. See, the curvy wervy is kind of good because it lets us kind of shoot guys from a much greater distance, which in this case almost got us killed. Whoa. So speaking of reviews, this game got pretty good scores. Zap64 gave this game a 96%, which is very high. And I can see why this game has such good scores, because the controls in it are actually pretty darn great. Nice, got him killed. Maybe there's a secret if you jump up there. Oh, speaking of secrets, maybe that's what the secret was. We'll get this guy yet. There we go. Oh, there's a little plant thing we gotta go across. So see, this is where this sort of powered up thing comes in handy, because now we can just shoot these guys from way the heck over here. And yeah, it's gonna take a while. But it's way better than this stupid thing, where you can't shoot at all. And you can get some pretty fast shots off if you get up next to somebody. So yeah, our Droopy is a little bit more leveled up. But at least we've got... Oh, come on! I was just trying to turn to hit him. Should have just held it down. Alright, well, we don't have a bad starting spot, so... We'll accept that death, I suppose. We'll get this guy with a flame instead, because it's so much faster. What other reviews do we have for this game here? I wonder if we can jump up here. Yeah, we can. Oh, we can make the jump sound go as fast as possible. We can take a damage in an inopportune time. So here we're going to go back to a droopy. Because it's the easiest way to kill these guys. Let it droop down. I have a feeling this is going to be a dead end that means nothing to us. Interesting. No, this guy's not taking damage. So my guess is this isn't a dead end that means nothing to us. It's a place where we really want to kill this guy. So we got our fire breath going. All right, it's probably this one here. Oh man, and bonus rewards. Nice. Okay. Hopefully that's something that comes back if we, okay, this fart is probably gonna be invulnerable. Nope. Nope. Those farts were methane gas that was completely blow-upable. Hopefully they don't respawn till we are gone. Alright, I can't imagine there's anything up there. This guy seems to be invulnerable, so... This guy seems to be invulnerable too. What the heck does that mean? Jeez, I can't imagine we're not going to take damage when we go. Let's climb up here for a second. See if maybe there's something going on. Jeez, these jumps. Come on. Thought I was going to die there. Man, I just can't make that jump. Maybe that is the case. Can we walk through this guy? I don't think we're going to be able to. Oh, jeez. Eek indeed. Where are we at? Okay, so you start Adam now and he's moving. Maybe he was supposed to be moving the whole time and the game just kind of glitched out to give me a hard time. But we've got the extra life again already, so... We know this guy's invulnerable. Fire breath on them. Nothing up my sleeve. Alright. There's only one easy way to beat this guy. The fire is definitely the way to go if you have to do some one of those little jumps. Alright, are you killable? The answer is yes, because you're flashing. But you don't flash, so you're not killable. Oh, there's a waterfall coming up. There's not a lot of commentary going on right now, because I really don't want to die again. Alright, if we change to... Yeah, you're trying to pull the same stuff, but this time I've got an attack. Too bad. Alright, small jump. I think we can manage to make this. Okay, it should be a fire breath to pull it over. Oh, not worth. I didn't move far enough over. However, given that we know... How does the super droppy work? Okay, so it drops, but it takes it quite a while to get there. Okay. I really think we can probably just... Nope, you know what? I don't trust myself to kill this guy. There we go. With a flame attack. Alright, not so bad. As long as we can get that one up every life, we won't be doing so bad. Oh, die! Jeez! Oh, gosh. Jeez, Jeez, I need to start practicing what I'm preaching here. All flame attacks all the time on these guys that I can reach without doing it. Definitely want the one up this time. So maybe it's just that very first area that I was pretty pissed off about, because it seemed very cheap stylish. And then in the end, it turns out it wasn't so bad. Is the one up back? Oh, the one up's not back this time. But you know what? I can do this on this guy. If I... I could get it to... And then if I change to... Well, you know what, realistically... I change to the drop C, but I can't change my attack once I'm on here. This is some great ABS. Okay, well, he takes damage. Where's he stop moving? Right next to this mushroom. So... Okay, this guy I can't hurt. You gotta like... Neither of these guys you can hurt. Okay, so... It's just gotta like... Try to make that jump? It's kind of another one of those BS zones. Alright, I got my fire ready. It's not enough to kill him. Two will, though. Jeez. Whoa. Right, you gotta love when you're just short enough. I don't know that we're gonna make it to the first creature thing without mad use of safe states. We're gonna save it right next to that freaking jump. Oh, there's probably a place that if you kill somebody, it gets rid of one of those guys. I bet. I'm gonna save a snapshot here just in case. Especially with a cat that can survive a fall. Holy life bar. Or maybe we just need to be using, you know, our more powerful attacks on these guys. Maybe then we'll be able to kill them. Maybe that's their way of making sure that we upgrade our weaponry. Okay, so it would appear that I just fucked myself pretty badly. Is there a way for me to get down here into this little zone that they seem to imply? Oh, it still works! Okay, that makes little to no sense, but I'm willing to go with it. I wonder if I have the fire breath and I get on this thing, what happens? Nothing. Okay, so let's get close to this guy. Yep, kind of broke the sprite a little bit there. So more powerful hits. It also makes more sense because I can... What?! Man, this is what I'm talking about. One thing I don't like about this game is that some spots they throw out... They're throwing shade, man. That's what they're doing. They're just throwing out an area that's just suddenly way too hard compared to everything else you've run into so far. Some sort of crazy jump. And you only have four lives. And, I mean, yeah, if that one life kept coming back there, it'd be a different story, but it doesn't. Make sure you have disc B in, because that's the play disc. I wonder if the dropsy on this guy would have killed him faster with the flame. I don't know if it makes your flame stronger as well. Well, make sure not to kill the frickin' leaf this time. I didn't even know that was an option. Skip that guy. This was a bad plan. Well, maybe it wasn't such a bad plan. Okay, somehow... Oh, it was strong enough to kill him this time, but not this guy. Okay. We get over... You know what? I'll take it. Good enough. We survived. Let's get some extra ingredients. You know what? I'm throwing a safety state down right here. I gotta perfect the rest of this level. Because... I don't know if I'll be lucky enough to pull that off again. Yeah, he's dead. We're slowly moving over here. Getting ourselves killed. not so great. Maybe I should have put another save state down sooner, but I am fine with trying to make it through with one hit point. I think if we don't get too greedy, we'll be able to pull this off. Said, make sure the right disk is in every time you load the state. I think we're still close enough to grab that guy. Oh, yes. Maybe we just need to kill this guy like this. It makes more sense. There was apparently maybe a really easy way to get across there, but we'll take this exit. Sorry, cat. Oh, hell no. What's up, cat? Oh, we're doing damage, and that's what really matters, I suppose. He's not close enough to... Hey! Not bad. Not bad at all. Ooh, don't fall in that water. You know what? This is going to be crazy now, but there's going to be save states galore. Because I do not want to have to go back through all this. Okay, we can't hurt that guy, but we can jump up there right behind him. Walk over, grab him, and leave. We can kill that guy from here. It seems like the greater distance you can kill guys from, the better off you are, because you know what? Last thing you need is one of them to transform like they every once in a while do and take you out. I don't think there's a spot here that I can successfully... Yeah, see, they made an extra strong one here to try to F us up. I think this guy, our best bet is, can we kill him from here? No, you know what? I have the drop attack. If it's not good enough to hit him, I don't want to hit him. I was going to think that he... Oh, he killed that guy over there. Is this worth the jump? Nope. Oh, well. So we're not going to go after those two bonus guys. I suppose, because it doesn't seem to be worth it. So anyways, I never got to the fuzzy that came in the game. Do you remember back, if you were alive in the 80s, early 90s, there was this, these little fuzzy guys. They were like a little puffball, right? So you got this little puffball, and then it had eyeballs attached to it. Just like two little googly eyes attached. Oh, thank God I killed that guy. And like some plastic feet, and some of them would have sunglasses, and maybe they'd have a nose made out of plastic or something, but realistically they were just plastic guys with, or little fuzz balls with these I'm saving it here, these little fuzz balls with googly eyes and a couple of big feet attached to them. Well, that's apparently just there to freak you out. Is that guy dying? Hey, he's done. What about these guys right below me, though? the challenge to shoot them from over here? It certainly is. Jerks. Yeah, you're dead. Okay, we're not doing so bad here. Are you killable? Very much so. You're not. But you are going to be probably important to kill, is the question. Is that the case? See if it did happen. So anyways, they put one of these in the box. And it came with the game, and it was a plush fuzzy wuzzy, or fuzzy, is that what these guys are called? Fuzzy wuzzies? I believe so. Oh, didn't make that jump. We only have one jump height here, so that's the danger. Is it high enough to jump from there? No, see? You gotta jump before this guy comes back. But you know what? Too bad for us. Apparently, if we had picked the fall up thing. What the hell is this? Holy crap. Okay, good thing we saved the state. we're gonna use the shoot across to try to shoot across there. Hopefully that works. But they had all sorts of stuff. The game pack came with this little fuzzy wuzzy with a treatment manual, and it said things like adoption. Let's use this guy. See how far to the side we can get before we trigger stuff. Maybe we can kill it before it can kill us. Oh, jeez. Now this thing's dropping freaking all kinds of shit. Oh god, there's no way! Jesus. Maybe you're supposed to run across as fast as you can. We'll try it again. So it has things like adoption. When purchasing creatures, you have adopted this fuzzy wuzzy automatically. The idea is you are his mother because it is the nature of things. That the fuzzy sees the light of the world it sees when you open the box. You can now give the little creature a name, but beware, historical records show that fuzzy wuzzies can be quite annoyed when they're called Mildred. Please read the following guidelines to take good care of your offspring in the appropriate way. As we load up the game here. Sex. Unfortunately, there's no way this can be determined with certainty. As a rule of thumb, if several fuzzy wuzzies are born, they are female. If only one is, they are male. Well, that was the worst possible start to that. The next thing is on feeding. No food on the planet has proven suitable for the digestive tract of the fuzzy wuzzies. Just experiment a little. Put your fuzzy at a set table and watch for its reaction. I'm really curious if I can freaking jump up there. No, it really seems like that's not a jumpable thing. I think we need to just once try, just... Getting far enough along didn't work. I think I've euchred myself. I'm not sure how you're supposed to freaking get through there. I really painted myself in the corner. Physical exercise. Fuzzy wuzzies love long walks in the countryside, but only if they are carried there. I'm wondering if I can get a... You're sure you're not taking damage? Yeah, you're not taking damage. Can we get started and leave? No, it seems like... Man, I don't know what they're doing with this second boss thing. Man. The other thing it says care, fuzzy wuzzies do not have an excessive urge to move and prefer to doze off in a place near you. Take care of your fuzzy with a feather duster is sometimes appropriate. Taking care of your fuzzy with a feather duster is sometimes appropriate. This activity is also very stimulating for the fuzzy wuzzy. Um, The training of the Fuzzy Wuzzy. Fuzzy Wuzzy being taught many tricks when growing up. For example, jumping through hoops is a specialty, although this will require some coaxing on your part. The next thing it talks is sausages. Beware of placing sausages, no matter whether cooked raw or frozen, in front of your Fuzzy Wuzzy, because it thinks sausages are natural enemies and will try to intimidate the sausage with its gaze, which isn't really actually that insulting or that worrisome, I suppose. And then the last thing, and most important, there is one rule that you must follow. Do not let your Fuzzy get wet. It cannot swim and is scared to death. So those are the instructions for your Fuzzy Wuzzy. We're going to try this one more time because of two reasons. One, it turns out that you can get up on that little ledge and you will get a bonus life if you do so. And two, I believe it might be possible for us to make it through this thing. So, let me just see. How we're gonna get up there. We gotta try to jump from here. Okay, that was a bad shot. I think we were at the right trajectory though. Just a bad shot. I just gotta jump right off that little ledge. Alright, let's try this again. I do wish that that guy wasn't invulnerable. I'll make sure we have disc B in. I'm gonna have to do this every time. Oh, this is gonna be so annoying. Oh, but look what we did! Oh, but you gotta get back out in time, too! Oh, man, this is gonna be a danger. Okay, so... holy crap. Okay, so if you've stuck with me this far, I guess you're gonna stick with me until we get this working. Because it's already... do you know what? This has taken so long, it's already after C64 Sunday has ended. Jeez, 47-minute video. Okay, it would appear that you wanna get close enough to that edge. It's like just there. Okay, this should be the jump that makes it. I was completely wrong, and I apologize. I understand that it's too late to apologize, but I do so anyways. Okay, so maybe you gotta be moving, but you gotta hold the button down right away as soon as you jump. Nope. Oh man, this is going to be so painful if I just had... and that's the type of enemy that would be completely invulnerable anyways. So... so I think that's what you gotta do is kind of like walk... jeez. And this is the problem with the up button being the jump button too, is that you try to turn left, you try to turn right, you accidentally flip to the upside a tiny bit. And you're dead. Now, geez, this guy didn't die when he was doing what I did. Let's, whoop. Nope. Whoop. It's almost annoying that we know it's possible now. Because... because I really want to try to get that extra life. Because having one hit point will make things a little bit easier. I mean, I understand you want to make a one-up hard to get, but a little bit... okay, this is supposed to be a safe place to stand, but it's not. How come it's a safe place to stand for this I got a little bit of a video here that showed me how this guy beat all this crap, and it certainly involves standing there while he's charging up and not taking a hit. Maybe you have to be walking to the right. Jeez. Well, maybe we'll try this without that. If you walk, how far do we have to go? Right there. All right. So, here's the deal, is that we can kill this guy with impunity here. And then we can throw down a save state and go after the last guy. We've got 400 seconds to take care of this. Only 200 bonus points. Jeez, I wish I had the extra life. See, and that's why we put a save state down, because we need to get down there, and once I get down there, I can follow the jump pattern pretty easily, but... Whoops, that is not the right save state. Once we get down there, it's going to be a little easier to jump across, but... Maybe I just need to fall and then jump. Make sure disc B is in, because we're actually likely to need it now. Alright, so we've pretty much got this now. So it wasn't so hard. If I had known where that invulnerability spot was, or not invulnerability spot, but the spot where the boss can't hit you, it might have made things a little bit easier, but realistically... It's actually not too bad once you know. Boom, loading, 1-3. Alright, so this is going to be... I'm going to throw a little save state down right here too, even though it's loading in the middle of the game. This is going to be the first sort of puzzle of the game. What we've got to do is we've got to save our friend. He's going to be in a torture machine. Just got a game error message. Oh gosh, I hope this loads. Jeez, don't tell me that there's a glitch in this version of the game. After all this work, yeah, CPU jam at FF9E. Start monitor, no reset, yes, well, yes? I don't know what jamming. Okay, so apparently you probably shouldn't put a save state while things are loading. We'll try this one more time from the second last save state. I gotta kill this stupid thing again. Perhaps if I get close enough, I can kill it with fire. Okay, just let it load. Insert side B. Insert side B. Load. All right, so turn off turbo. And now we save the state. So let that be a lesson to you. Never save the state while the game is in the middle of loading. It will break it, for sure. We have to rescue Chip as soon as possible. So where are we starting here? Right here next to this guy. Shoot. Luckily, this guy is ignoring us for now. But we've got to hurry. It is possible to kill this guy. Alright, he's out of the way. Now we gotta come over here. Is that guy shitting out monsters? He is! He's making monster crappers. Okay. Gotta get up here. Come on, get up! Get up! Get up on it! Oh, come on. What a stupid jumping platform. There we go. Okay, we can get up from there. Oh, jeez. He's starting a chainsaw. I'm using the wrong attack, maybe? How do I push this? Oh god, he murdered him! Alright, somehow I had a life still. Oh man, you can flame while you're walking. There we go. Okay, this is gonna be faster already. So hopefully, don't mess up these jumps too bad. Already too late. Alright. Can we jump here? Nope, we can jump here. Oh, jeez, there was a frickin' poop monster. Alright. Alright, game over there, but we got two more chances here. Now, I'm supposed to be able to... light the fire, yeah. Oh, I loaded the wrong state. That's the initial state where the game is perfectly fine. That's the state I need. Okay, so apparently we can only move this boulder when the saw is running, which is part of the issue we had. Alright, so we got a flame on here. Apparently you can just do it like that. It's a little bit faster, actually. Okay, shoot your little poop. Flame. Shoot your little poop. Flame. I think it takes three of these. Alright, no poop this time. Okay, well, maybe we can't move it till unless the saw's not running. Oh, I killed myself! Shoot, okay, so, boom. I think we got this. You could see I had it going, I just didn't get out of the way of getting killed by the... Alright, so I'm take three of these. Plan it right, there's no... Get out the way! Alright, didn't die. Alright, that little guy up there, he's gonna get a saw, maybe? Well done! Okay, so it only took us an hour, but we beat the first level, cheating as much as possible. Clyde has saved Chip from being sliced in two. Chip offers Clyde his collection of magic potion creatures as a reward. Without hesitation, Clyde accepts them to continue on his quest. So you see, we have 21 things now. But until we beat the next level, we wouldn't be able to upgrade. And it's important to upgrade the right way, because there's certain things that... I think it's the third torture chamber. You have to have Flamer as level blue, at least. You'd better be careful. Let me help you, Clyde. Here's some of my magic potions. So you see we have enough ingredients now to level up some of this stuff. We have Scatterball. I mean, that would be pretty awesome to have. Flamer, which is apparently a pretty good one. You need it at least level blue for the final chamber, which we can't get to right now. So, like, you almost want to save some of this stuff up. Make sure you get Flamer set to level blue. But real quick, let's just look at what Flamer does, and then we'll call it a video. So we've got this. See, look at this. Look at this attack. Boom. And because it just stays in the air a little more, it's a little bit more... Ah, this guy's invulnerable to it. But what about Dropsy? Yep. So, I mean... There's still going to be monsters that are invulnerable, or... immune to certain things. This guy's doing a little dance. Probably make a little love and get down tonight. Maybe he's invulnerable. No, there we go. We got him to move upwise. And again. And now he's down. Interesting. There we go. Now he's dead. So, I mean, things. The more things change, the more things stay the same. We're still doing all the same stuff. There's three of these levels. I suggest checking this game out for yourself. It's a pretty good game. As frustrated as I've gotten, you can see if you had all this stuff memorized, you'd be perfectly fine getting through this game. And you know what? Maybe you're gonna cheap styles it up here and not go down there. Whoop. Shoot, all these guys are like invulnerable to this crap. Is it because it's not green? Yeah, don't fall down here. It's bad. Oh, see, I would have made that a jump if I hadn't jumped terribly. Oh, that guy was a balloon. So yeah, there's all sorts of new monsters and everything. And if you can get through this level, there's another torture chamber for you. This one with an Acme... instead of an Acme lift, it's an Acme... torture chamber has an Acme sawmill. And the last one has an Acme arm that's trying to push the guy to the end. So, and the weird thing is it's almost kind of like... they want you to let the guy die once so that you can see what it's like. Anyways, I'm Zerfall. This has been Creatures. And next time on C64 Sunday, if you check out the Twitter, you can vote on what game we're going to play. Thanks for watching. Sorry about rambling so much, but at least we got one in the can.